to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Any comments by visitors this evening? Tracy Lurie.
Tracy Lurie, thank you for last night and your patience and for the support that we had for the school board and for your flexibility with not having all of our equipment and setups. You did a fabulous job. So thank you very much for pushing through that and continuing. But that was a bit of a fiasco of fun.
It was good to get it done because we actually have a short time frame to work on the budget, so it's good to work out. Appreciate it all around.
Yes.
Any other comments from visitors? All right, I'll move on to consent calendar. On the consent calendar, move for discussion. We have the minutes from our budget workshop on the 9th, November 9th. We have the minutes of our regular school board meeting on November 9th. The minutes of the budget workshop that we have on November 28th and December enrollment. What's the pleasure, folks?
Also help raise money for the club. So happening right now tonight is what's called the Quarter Concert at the high school. That was the last one, it was one day before I thought it was back, but, yeah, it's, we're wanting to make grade 6 or 12. It's just a, another opportunity for, students from the, every school, the marching district to, work together on, fund the raise money and,
That's what we, I mean, that's what everyone gets to know, so, for some.
And, yeah, it's pretty much it, coming up this weekend, it's a, it's a movie night, but also a raise money, the holiday thing, which is, hang on, it's quite intense, but, and, we meet on Friday, 22nd, it's a school vacation. Last, lost entire 2 weeks this year.
That's right, we meet small, so, but do you go to school on the 22nd, or do you?
No, we're, first at 21st, it's the last day. Last year, it's something short.
Thank you, Tom. And, we'll move on to the, summer words, to the word, Bailey?
So, the state council is hosting their annual clothes drive, it's like 7th or 8th year, for Janus. That's tomorrow night from 5, 7 p.m. in the high school cafeteria. We have like an overwhelming amount of clothes here, which is really awesome. We actually have boxes here, people, all sorts of people, also donated, which is greatly appreciated. And then, we're also planning winter spirit week next week, before next week. Just to get more festive, kind of, use everyone's morale together, as well as push for vacation. Our interact club is selling cake and crams during all lunches this weekend next, hand out on next Friday. Our National Honor Society has been very busy, we're planning a trip to Washington DC at the end of January, to attend a conference. So, kind of finalize the details for that. We're also doing gift wrapping for Toys for Tots, fire station, some sorts, we can have people go here and there to support that cause. We're donating gift cards to help the student councils clothes drive tomorrow night, so there's a little raffle for people. And then, we're also doing a teacher luncheon tomorrow, and staff members will be there for teacher workshop day. And we're planning Barnes and Noble fundraiser that we have every year, beginning of January. So, this year, it falls on January 6th, from 10 to 2, that's just a fundraiser to help us really serve general funds, so we can give back. As far as classes go, our freshman class is playing, March Madness fundraiser, which is a senior versus staff game. The sophomore class is playing Valentine's Day dance, junior class is focusing on their fall fashion show fundraiser, which is a huge, huge amount of work. It always comes off, comes together so well, and it's just an amazing day. And then, the senior class is focusing on collective graduation, and we're just considering venues for that, as well as selling senior shirts. As far as sports go, basketball season has begun, teams have really gotten the ball rolling. We've already had a few games here and there. Winter track practices have already begun as well. The Unified Basketball has their first practice next week, we have a new coach this year, Shane Chick, who is the voting rights teacher at high school. He's very excited, all the partnership people are very excited, all the partners are excited, just lots of excitement.
And you do have school next Friday?
We do have school, yeah, the 22nd is our last day.
Thank you both very much. As usual, you are very welcome to stay, and if you would like to, however, I also know that you're busy people, and it's also okay if you sign up. The next discussion item is about the New Hampshire School Board others, we have never, like, other school boards want to have certain things go before the legislature, and so they move forward and then go to vote there whether or not we want to have our national school associations support those and take them forward. It's a very interesting day. That said, sometimes there are other things going on. Action items this week. When we get to the budget, we'll talk, but we need to finalize the warrants tonight. We'll finalize as far as we can on the warrants tonight. So we'll do that in the next, on the budget. Then the budget, now we're talking about the current budget, this year's budget. Does anyone want to make any statements or comments? Any statements or comments you would like to make? It's in very good shape. And so I guess my first question is that, as far as we know, have we encumbered special ed yet? We have not. Not completely. We've encumbered some, but not.
We have not encumbered any of the Marshwood special ed at all.
Okay, so it's not, so it's the Marshwood special ed, because I see that we still have quite a chunk of it.
The Summersworth portion is.
Okay. All right. Yeah. And do you have any guess as to what might be encumbered now?
Invoices were just approved, okay. So it's going to be incorporated in the next cycle,
okay.
Which is next week. Next week, Kate's going to run another payroll, because our last payroll for the year is the 29th of December, and the office is closed. So that assembly class is the week before. So you will get notice Thursday on the 21st to come and sign the manifest. Because as of Monday, well, Monday's Christmas, but as of the whole week of the 25th, I say you all the 24th.
Right, oh, that's right, as it usually is over the holidays. Right, but they will be ready on the 21st, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
At least by the end of the day on the 21st.
All right, thank you. All right. So, right. Any other questions on the current budget? Then we'll move on to.
I do have a question. At the last board meeting, the board was kind of looking at doing the tour.
Yes.
I didn't know if that was something you'd want to encumber at this point in time. And then. Moving forward, when you get closer to the period encumbered, so that it's being accounted for, if that's the wish of the board.
Yes, as I remember our discussion, anyone jump in here, the discussion was that we wanted to get that encumbered, make it official, have it encumbered, so that as soon as any work can happen, Dick can work with whoever it is.
The thing is, just it looks like that. It's falling apart. You've got chicken wire around it. I don't think we don't need to make a big circus out of it. I think we just need to do it. You know, the whole idea of grant money, I get, you know, what we were talking about, but this is more of a more concerned about it being a safety issue, too. I mean, there are cases clearly falling apart. We don't want anybody to get hurt. So I think if we can do it, we have money to do it. Let's do it.
Yeah. And we know we do, because we know we have the SAU assessment. We're not the full assessment. So.
And my understanding is that the applying for the grant is going to be substantially more cost.
Substantially more cost, yes.
Than
So we have a quote of about $5,000, and so I guess we can entertain a motion to recover $5,000 to use for the roof repair.
I would like to suggest giving ourselves a little bit of a buffer on top of that. We really, I mean, we don't want to like put ourselves in a spot where we're only a lot of $5,000, and a little bit more, so I would recommend perhaps $7,500, just as a, I mean, we may not use it all, but if you have it there, and that way it's
other folks?
And then, well, for one man, is that?
Well, we have an estimate, it's a, I believe we've only received one
correct
quote on that, one estimate on that.
And that way, if there are any unanticipated issues, problems, when they get up there and start tearing the line, we've got one.
That's fair. And at this moment, we're just encumbering them.
Right,
because
right.
Because now will be done until after it gets a little less icy.
Right.
So we'll have time to discuss this further. All right, so then a motion to...
Well, I make a motion if you need one to cover $7,500 for a repair.
Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye. Yes.
The other thing for to consider when the budget for next year was presented in the maintenance line, I think it was doors and security.
Yes.
That was something else the board had discussed.
Yes.
If you want to wait, that's one thing. If you can come with money, then I'm able to do this right away anyway.
Right.
So that you secure that money, and then again, that would be towards the savings from the SAU.
Yes. Yes, and we did remove it from the budget.
For next year, with the intent to do it this year, we might have seen.
Yeah, it was about 12 or 13. It was about 13. It was about. I have it here, but about 13.
If I'm not mistaken, we already did phone.
No, the phone and alarm is much more.
Right.
So that's staying in. That's staying in our budget.
I couldn't remember one.
It's about 13. And that's a firm report. All right. You know what, something we want to address now, we have $16,800 that we were not counting on that's going to be in this year's budget. Obviously, we've already covered $7,500, so that would put us over that amount, but it still doesn't hurt. There's no problem with encumbering it, but we don't uncover it sometimes, right?
Right.
Yeah. Well, remember also that we may have, on the people side, we may have a little bit extra left over after that. I just suggested that amount in case it does. But, so are we planning on trying to use that money now?
Well, that's why we were coming in for the cupola. And
no, I meant for the door.
Yes, for the safe and secure door, so that work can take place as soon as possible. Any of us who have tried to get in and do anything, that's...
So do you need a motion to do that?
Well, we did a motion to the covers for the cupola, so I think we should.
Okay. Well, I make a motion that we set aside amount of $13,000 to work on the door, so let's discuss the business.
Second. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
So thank you for the reminders on that. Anything else on this year's budget? All right, now let's talk a little bit about thing on what it says here is review of the budget presentation that we did last night. And one of the things that came out of that is finalizing the warrants. We can't finalize the collective bargaining agreement yet because we're still in negotiations for that. So we had talked about, I believe, two possible ones. One is the roof, the annex and kindergarten roof, which I did go back into the IBEA study, and the annex roof was due to be replaced in 2012, so it's 6 years behind, and the kindergarten roof was due to be replaced in 2018, so it would be right on time if we go forward with this one. So, and I know that when we had one estimate, I don't know if it's a physical quote or it's a quote, of about 100,000. 93,000. Will we be getting any more?
It's called several others. It's hard to find two flat roofs.
Yep. Yes, it's difficult. It's difficult to find people who work on flat roofs. And, I will say that, I mean, so you said that that's 93, you said?
Yes.
That is very close to what was in the IBEA study, and that was 5 years ago. That study was about 4 or 5 years ago. So that is really...
Well, I have a question.
Yeah.
And I think this is more... You're saying that the kindergarten group...
According to that study.
So, you could not, I mean, so when they came out, did they think, seem to think that the kindergarten roof needed to go down? Having them both done, and it would be cheaper to have them both done, okay, but if it was really not going to be that big of a cost savings, and the kindergarten roof could have waited, and I would have said, why not do the main portion, whatever that was going to cost. I mean, I think either way, we should put the more forward. I don't think we really have a choice as far as this one, 6 years.
And the seam, I think, is what it is most, is the biggest concern to Dick, as the facilities director, from what I understand. So,
well, any water damage that comes through it is not quite, it'd be a lot worse.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, well, we'd be losing the whole wing if they got rid of it.
So.
I don't think there'd be cost savings to do it at all.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Everyone get that?
Yeah.
So it comes down to how much. Well, we have a solid quote for 93. And so we can put, you know, if by any chance somebody comes forward and can do it for less, that would be great, but I think we would have to have a warrant to do it for 93. How do people think that makes sense?
Yeah. I mean, it's, you know, if it's being requested now, we're not. It's not a frill, it's a roof, so it has to be.
All right, so that will be one warrant. And I don't really vote on that. What do we do? Well, I don't think I would vote on that.
Well, I make a motion then to move forward with the warrant to replace the annex roof with the kindergarten roof. Just not to exceed 93,000. That's what
that's the quote. Yes.
Okay.
93,000. Awesome. Any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Yeah, the actual wording will probably say that gets put together.
It's, yeah, it's
you'll fix it.
It's really, it's dictated by the department, so.
And the other one we talked about was building up our building capital reserve. It has 110 or so in it now, I think.
103.
103, that's right. Interesting number. It has 103 in it now. We do have some big ticket items coming down, but I am not going to recommend to the board that we put anything more in our sped reserve fund. It's got about 155, I believe. So, you know, it would cover us for, it could be one student, but it could be more, right? I'm not going to recommend bringing anything in. So whatever we decide to put aside, and that, now this is only if we have funds left over, because unless we think we want to go to the town and say, and raise by taxation money to put into that. But I think this year it might be good to go with no tax impact and put it in if we have it left over. So we just have to think about the amount. I think 25,000 is actually too low with what's coming up. We've done 25 and 25 in past years. We've done 50 and 50.
Yeah.
I think that's as high as we've ever gone, is 50 and 50.
Well, I didn't get the impression last night that there was a really good grasp by the budget commission that was really what we fly over that. But you know, when you've got a boiler, you got other things, plus that's not to mention, you know, those uncontrollable things we can't predict. So I think it's just we're trying to, you know, go ahead and prepare. You're not, you know, we don't want to be behind it. We really want to make sure we've got money in there. And that way we're say, well, we need to have this done, but it's going to cost money. So rather than going in and saying, hey, by the way, we need $300,000, we need this amount, you know, I agree with you. $5,000 is almost, you know, it's like a gratuity.
I was just going to throw out a figure of $75,000 if we had it.
Right.
And it would be, it's the last warrant, so all the other warrants would be for, you know, happen first, so it's only if you have it left over.
But again, I think the explanation really, I mean, it needs to be perfectly clear. This is not, we have a lot of things we're going to have to pay for, and they're, unfortunately, they're not cheap. So
in the next two or three years, there's some big ticket items. There's a boiler, there's looking at a safe and secure entrance to this building, which is that's costly. And then they're saving for the roof, the main building.
What's the cost for that?
It's about $300. I have it here. I can look it up. The getting a safe and secure entrance. It's about $300,000. IBEA did not cover security. They made it very clear that that was something they did not cover, but they knew it needed to happen. It's worth looking into Homeland Security on that, certainly. Homeland Security came through very quickly on the cameras. So.
No, I mean, is that something that they would cover?
I don't know. I would have to. I'm not an expert on that. We'd have to find out about Homeland Security. Yeah. I mean, I found out about the camera one from the police chief. So, we have to.
It's
worth exploring. Yeah, it is.
Why do
you want to? That was almost painless. That was almost a painless event. I think it came to the
I do want to make a motion that we increase the amount, whatever is left over. No higher than 75,000. Now, if it doesn't meet 75,000,
it would be up to. That's okay. One that is up to 75,000.
And I think I would make that motion that we state that we would take whatever is left up to $75,000 towards our building fund.
Can I just point that out?
Yes, please.
It's a firm number. If you decide it's $75,000, that's what it is. And then what happens is your fund balance at the end of the year, you can't put anything more than that. It's assumed. So the language is not up to. If that's what the board.
Your reason I set up to.
But it's, right, so if you only have $60,000, that's all that will come in there.
Okay, but it doesn't have.
That's what we wanted to make sure.
It doesn't have to reach that threshold, that's what I.
No.
Okay, yeah, that's.
It's assumed that. It's assumed, if that's what the board decides, whatever's left over, that's what it's assumed. Anything less than that will not, you know, get less than that, the only thing will go in there is what's left.
Yes, sir.
Do we have any idea how soon the boiler or the paint roof?
The boiler is soon. We'll have to do more work, like, you know, we'll be starting to talk about it next year. About what we, you know, and how quickly it'll have to happen. And it may be a combination of whatever we have in the building fund plus going out to the.
Within the next few years.
Within the next year or two, and I don't think you need to go that long. The safe and secure entrance is going to take some time, so we'll also have to start working that up, start looking at grants, start looking at other things like that. The roof, we have time to save for, it's like 2025, yeah.
That's true.
Yeah, so we've got 5 or 6 years of the main debt in the building. We've got 5 or 6 years to try and save. And those are the big ticket items to do now. And there are lots of other little things. The windows in the main building.
Stockings.
Stockings, the windows in the main building, because they're a safety hazard. Even an adult can't, they're so heavy, you can't open them, close them, they need like, they need like spotters and. So things like that.
So $75,000 is not.
Oh, it's not, no, it's a drop in the bucket for what we need. But it's prudent to start putting money aside, I think, sure. So we've had a motion and a second, I believe. And any further discussion or clarification? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, motion carries. And I think that's it, other than, now, while we're on the subject, we are still in negotiations. We certainly hope to come to an agreement, and everything needs to be finalized by January 9th, I believe. So we will have to have a special meeting once we tentatively agree with the union on a collective bargaining agreement, we will have to be again to be accepted, as they will have to be accepted. Ratify, right, we have to ratify, and they have to ratify, and then we have, then it goes to, then it becomes a warrant article. So just letting you know that we will hopefully be having a meeting. I'll get, you know, we'll get email out, Tom and I will get email out to everyone once we know.
But January 9th?
That's the latest, that's the very last moment that it can be. So we will hopefully, we may meet between, you know, I don't know when it's going to be. I don't know when it's going to be. It will be, I don't know when it will be, but chances are it will be after Christmas. But we'll see, but we'll let you know. So that's where you'll keep your fingers crossed and we'll get to that. The same thing happened last year. We have to get together for something very quickly, just before finalizing the warrant time. All right, so that takes.
I have a question.
Yes.
I may have misunderstood, but I thought I heard somebody, the board member, mention that they would like to maybe start a new trust fund.
Oh, thank you, yes, I was going to bring that up. I'm not sure I want to do this year, but I wanted to mention that we could start new trust funds. We can start putting money aside for things.
anytime we want to, in essence, we have to put them in as a warrant and start the trust fund. But one that I was thinking of, that I heard mentioned recently, is that there are other districts that have tuition trust funds. So rather than building in like two contingencies for tuition or two contingency students, we could actually have a trust fund that maybe we get up to a certain amount of money, like even just $20,000. That's two students right now in Marshfield. So that we don't have to put it in our operating budget. We could decide what the mat, we could start it with something and we could decide what we wanted to do for the mat. I'm just throwing that out as an idea.
And can we do it the same way we've added to our other funds, as in monies left over?
Yes. Yes.
Just as a information purposes, in order to start a trust fund, you need to appropriate money. So you could appropriate a dollar, and that would. So 1 year. So 1 year, if the board so wishes to establish a trust fund, the first year you establish the dollar, whatever it is, the following year you start funding. Or you just leave it at a dollar, you know it's there, whenever it's necessary, you do that. So that is something boards can do, is open the trust fund. And the first year's active is getting it active.
It gets it
and active. And then you fund it. That's an easy way to open
the fund. So it gets it set up and then start adding to it. We are going to be paying tuition for the foreseeable future. We don't have a middle and high school, so we know we're going to be paying tuition. I think it's very prudent to be having somebody to decide when we can take it out of our operating budget going forward. I like what we just said, that maybe we establish it this year with $1.
Is there a cost associated with having it?
No. No, it would just be like
it's
the
just
other
stuff. It's just not paid for
that. I mean, no, there's no cost. I mean, we're getting very little interest on it right now.
And on a dollar, it won't be anything.
You know, it's less than a dollar. Just a thought. Just like information purposes. I'm not going to be here, so you keep that as
no. I appreciate it. I think that if we think this is a good direction to go in, that we might as well establish it this year. Does it really?
But is there anything else we would want to establish a trust fund for? I mean, are we talking about? You're saying we try to get some things out of the operating budget, but I mean, technology, is that something that we could do that with, or is that not possible? I mean, to try to offset some of these things,
down the line. My understanding is that we can establish a trust fund for pretty much anything that we know is going to be an expense.
So how are we going to feed this?
Well, the same way the building trust fund works, or the same way the special ed trust fund works, is the way the school, the district has been doing it so far, is that we have always used money that we have not expended, at least in my time on the board. We can actually have a warrant that says we want to raise by taxation money to put in there. So that's how it gets funded. That's what you're asking.
Or, for any given year, if we didn't use this year, we could allocate it two or three.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Which we need a warrant.
Which we need a warrant.
We need a warrant to divert.
Yes. So we need to set it up, and then we need to.
Which we don't need a warrant.
No, yes, we need a warrant to set it up.
I just took that out. I mean, it doesn't have to be a dollar.
No, you're just saying just to set up. I mean, I don't really think
And you have to be careful of the purpose of that trust fund, because the way it's worded is the only way you can draw money on it.
Right.
So it's very specific.
It has to have a specific use, which is what it would, but it's I'm just trying to figure out how, you know, how you, you know, what the mechanics.
Yes.
I mean, if you're setting up and you have to set a warrant, you should have a warrant this year then to set it up. Because even if we're not funding it, we still have to. So
yeah, you have to put some, you have to put, you have to put something in there.
I'll pay for that. You don't even have to raise the
Yeah, and like every trust fund, if we needed those funds, that has to be a warrant too to take the money out. We also need the public's permission to use that money, as well as, I believe, the Department of Education and whoever else has to get involved in it. But at least we know we have the money, and it's something that will not and then get out of our operating. And you're right, I believe if we have specific purposes. I don't want us to go too crazy and set up like 20 times trust funds, but if you think about it,
sure,
good ideas.
That's the only thing I want for right now.
Yeah. So what do people think about doing it this year? Setting it up.
Yeah. Sure.
What's the purpose of
tuition? And can it be that general, or do we have to specify 7-12, the tuition for 7-12, tuition expenses, or regular tuition?
I don't know.
All right.
I just want to get a sense of what the board's intent is.
I think regular tuition. We already have a special ed fund.
Right.
So that would cover special ed costs. Regular tuition. That would we need it for what we already have the tuition contract for. And I don't know how specific it has to get, but for regular tuition.
So would you like to get the right language in order to have that?
Yes.
Please.
Just asking. I don't want to make assumptions, I'm asking.
Okay. And we don't have to specify the school, right?
No. And that's really good. That's good. So I guess following everything else, there should be a motion saying that we'd like to
make a motion to set up the trust fund for tuition for $1.
Well, I'm just going to clarify that.
Which
I will pay. I'm going to clarify it's still $1, okay? I'll clarify it.
If it's more, then you and I have to talk.
I won't be here.
you're a shady one after talk.
Can I second?
All right, any further discussion? Any further discussion? She's getting giddy because this is the last meeting she's out of the bus. I wasn't there to see if I was saying that. All right. So at the moment we have the operating budget, an unknown collective bargaining warrant. This is the order that they will show up in. The roof will be the next one in order because, again, as funds, we're going to use the funds in this way. Then the building fund, 75, and then the tuition, the new tuition trust fund. All right. Thank you all. That was very good. Is there any new business? Community connections, the FAQ, I think a new one went out, right?
Yes, there's a new FAQ available. About how Marshwood tuition is calculated, and it's up on the SAQ website.
Excellent. You did a nice job with that.
Thank you.
Yeah, and I was sure I've already. Before we go on to the next item, which is the Marshwood contract items, while I was researching some information for that, I came across the dates of the contract. So Dr. Brown now has added to that list that it looks like some of the dates were wrong in the contract. So we'll get those straightened out as we move forward too. Oh, bizarre. I don't know. Hard to tell.
It is.
I think so. I'm pretty sure it's a cut. Yeah. But those will be straightened out, and again, it was very clear that we'll be meeting in, we'll be meeting next year, I think, all of those items. So.
Anything else on community connections? And I know we missed one of the late, we missed the most current, March the late start. We missed it because they actually don't give a homeowner notice for one thing, but beyond that.
Right, it's pretty early, 3 o'clock, and I was in France, so that didn't work out too well. But so I received an update yesterday, for that. However, I do know that they were working towards getting a consensus from the group on regarding the start time at the middle school and high school. And then they wanted to present that consensus to their board of directors in February.
Oh, okay.
I know that that's what they're working towards.
What are they talking about as far as times?
I got a sense, I mean, I wasn't at this last meeting, so I can't really speak to it, but I got a sense that their feeling was the location of Marshwood being on the southern part, most part of the name, is a more difficult location, really, especially with after-school activities, for traveling, in particular sports, to other parts of Maine. But I will try to get that updated.
We'll look forward to an update on that, because that's obviously something that's affecting the time, especially if they're the first one to do it.
Right, some of the schools that came and spoke to us were more centrally located in Maine, and their activities were, a lot of the schools that they were, versing or going against, even with more legal to them. So I travel.
I would have thought of them, but yeah. My school district. Thank you. Future meeting dates. Just want to remind our board that we do have the final interview with the superintendent candidate on December 18th. That's Monday. It will be held at the SAU office, 6:30. So it will be the final interview, and then we will be deliberating. As well as our January 11th school board meeting. And January 13th, soon follow up. The budget committee's presentation of the school board, of the school budget, and their deliberation. That time's not right on that one, right? No. It's at 9 a.m., right? I've just noticed that was wrong. That's a Saturday meeting. Saturday meeting. Any school events you'd like to mention? I know you've been very busy.
My date is January 25th.
January 25th. You'll get a chance to tell us if you can talk about that, too.
Hopefully better than this.
And does Ross for grades well? I can look it up on the calendar. Have school the 22nd.
Yes.
Yes. That's right.
We're going to the movies, everybody.
That's nice. Excellent. All right. Closing comments by visitors.
I just need a point of clarification on the Warren article for the $75,000. Now, if it's for $75,000, if the consensus of the group votes it down, does that mean that it doesn't come out of that year? You can't take it out of the year you're in? Do you know, we've had a problem before where it wasn't clear to the people as to where the money was coming out of, and people were voting thinking that it was coming out of the 19 budget, but it would actually be coming out of the 18 budget for the 75,000, correct?
Yes, and we'll make sure that's clear. We'll make sure that's clear when the warrant is discussed. Any other closing comments by visitors?
Quick question on posting for this next meeting you're going to have for the warrants. How soon are you going to be able to post them? You can give us 24 hours, so.
It will only be on the collective bargaining.
Yeah, I know that.
And it will be non-public until it will come out of non-public to take the vote. But we'll first have a non-public meeting, and then we'll come out of non-public to take the vote. So negotiations aren't public until it's ratified by both. So you know, we'll ratify it in public, but we'll be non-public while we discuss it.
Understand.
And it'll be as soon as we know.
I know.
As soon as we know, we'll get it posted.
And it will be posted?
Yes. Any other comments by looking visitors, as we get all the business done at the office here? All right. Closing comments by board members. Happy holidays to all. I have one closing comment. Which I will not make. But we all know who in this room we're going to miss, and who we're going to welcome in. So we'll make it about Kate. We'll make it about Kate. Just for a moment, we'll make it about Kate. Amy has been has worked in the SAU office for a very, very long time. I think probably the longest.
She needs a little bit more.
She's a little more than
16.
Yeah, 16 years with me. And for the last 10 years, she's been fortunate to be working with Marie Dagostino. And therefore, we know that Marie's work ethic and her support of all of us will be carried on in the future. So we will miss her, we will all miss Marie, but we welcome you very much, Katie, and we look forward to working with you as we go forward. So thank you. So thank you for all of that. Any other? All right, then I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
Motion,
man. Motion, man. Who do we have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
People, this was a miracle under an hour.